Hi everyone, it's Marsha with the Marsha Grove Realty team, and I'm back with your Market Minute. I know it has been a while. I deeply apologize, but I am back with my weekly updates to fill you in on what's happening in our market. So stay tuned. All right, so we have 187 active listings in our MLS right now. That is a historic low amount of inventory. I don't think in the whole time that I've been a realtor that I have seen that little inventory. In the last 7 days, 72 new listings have come to market, 98 pending sales. So that means that 98 buyers and sellers have entered into a purchase agreement. And if they were lucky enough to have any conditions in the offer, those are all firmed up. There's nothing standing in the way now. And now they just wait for closing date. And they're probably relieved that they're not home hunting anymore and competing with other buyers. 173 properties have closed. So 173 people have gotten the keys to their new home. So this historic low amount of inventory is the reason for this uptick in house prices. If you've been shopping in the market in the last week, almost 2 weeks since the new year has started, I mean, you know, December we saw record-breaking numbers as well. But, you know, we're seeing some really crazy numbers. Townhomes that are listed at around 500,000 are selling for 625 and 640. You know, we haven't seen numbers like this. In 2017 is when we really saw a really aggressive seller's market. And 2020 was a strong market, there's no doubt. But this is unlike anything that I have seen. And I've spoken to a lot of my colleagues, and we're all, you know, agreeing that what's happening in the market, it seems like overnight, there's more buyers than ever, and there's just not enough homes for sale. So if you have been sitting on the fence about making a move, but are concerned with what's going on with the state of the world right now, and you know, today we had a stay home order for all of us to stay home and only go out if absolutely necessary. I want to reassure you that we've been taking all precautions pretty much all of 2020, and we're ready for whatever gets thrown at us. So we are only allowing one showing at a time. And only your realtor and the buyers, so two buyers and one realtor, are allowed in the property. Everybody wears their PPE, and we have our Lysol wipes and our hand sanitizer, and we are making sure that all of the lights are on before showing start for the day with our sellers, to ensure that buyers, agents, and buyers have to touch as little as possible while in the house doing their showings. And if you're concerned about what do I do with all of these showings, now that we're only allowing one at a time, and in most cases, they're only 15-minute increments to allow for more buyers to see the property, we're no longer overlapping showings. It's, you know, it's putting more of a demand on how long a homeowner has to be out of their home to allow for as many showings as possible. And so it's encouraged with really popular listings that the homeowner not be at home so that they don't have to leave so much. If you are able to stay with family, you know, we have these conversations before going to market, and you know, to discuss all of the logistics and see what is within your comfort level. And if that means that limiting showings to certain times of the day to allow for you to be, you know, out of the house, but still be safe, and you know, limit the amount of time that you have to be out of the house, we can do that. We can work within whatever your comfort level is. So just wanted to, you know, to reassure you on that. We have these conversations every day with our clients to make sure that we are helping you buy and sell real estate, because, you know, that can't stop. We all need a place to live, and COVID has really put that pressure or that awareness on a lot of the consumers out there that they've realized they need more space. Now that more and more people are working from home and more people are encouraged to work from home and there's no sign of when they'll be going back to an office setting, people are realizing more and more that they need more space. And, you know, we want to help facilitate that, but at the same time, keep everybody safe and work within everybody's comfort levels. Don't hesitate to reach out at any time if you have questions. If you are thinking of buying and selling, you want to get into the market, what does that look like? What does multiple offers mean in bidding wars, and how do you navigate through that? Let us know. We can start with a conversation just to provide some clarity on that, and then talk about next steps if it is the right time for you. I can say though that whatever price point that you'd be shopping in, so let's say your budget is $700,000, we need to be looking at homes that are listed at between $500,000 and $550,000, so that you have room to compete, because you will be competing with other buyers. That's just the nature of our market right now, and it has become even more so in the last couple of weeks. So we're prepared. We know how to navigate through this and how to guide you and keep you educated and informed and safe. So again, I can't stress enough, let's start with a conversation to eliminate any questions and fears that you have. Number one question, how's the market? How does it work during COVID that I get, whether it be on the phones or on virtual meetings and things like that. So I can talk real estate all day, as you can see. This video is a little long. So I'm going to sign off now, but definitely reach out at any time. You can call, you can text, email, you can reach out to me on social media. Happy to help. Always have a great day. Talk to you soon.